Psalm 107 verses 23 to 24, 25 to 26, 28 to 29, and 30 to 31. Give thanks to the Lord, His love is everlasting. They who sailed the sea in ships, trading on the deep waters, these saw the works of the Lord, and His wonders in the abyss. His command raised up a storm wind which tossed its waves on high. They mounted up to heaven, they sank to the depths, their hearts melted away in their plight. They cried to the Lord in their distress, from their straits He rescued them. He hushed the storm to a gentle breeze, and the billows of the sea were stilled. Rejoiced that they were calmed, and He brought them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for His kindness and His wondrous deeds to the children of men.
As you know, Israel is bordered by the Mediterranean Sea. Sailing during biblical times presented many potential dangers to those who go down to the sea in boats. Storms that come into our lives just like storms on the sea will eventually blow over and cease to be fearful. When a storm comes into our lives, it is important to continue to pray not only for the ending of the troubling times but also in thanksgiving for God's many blessings we accept or just take for granted. Praying will also give us peace in times of turbulence. This psalm invites the people to praise God for their return from the Babylonian exile. The Bible speaks about the three times the Israelites were exiled from their own country. The first to be deported were in 597, and there is some evidence that they became forced labor, or slaves, in Babylon. All three groups had been brought back to their own country through God's grace and mercy. Verses 23 to 27 describe sailors' work and terrors of the storm. The storm, like the Babylonian captivity, made people fearful. They came to realize that only God could save them. Rocking boat frightened the sailors, their boat might sink without God's help. God gave them a full measure of grace and mercy and had again saved His people. It's our tendency after experiencing a near-death, or life-threatening experience to wipe our brow, and say we were just lucky to have avoided death. Was it really luck or was it God working in our lives? Was our life-threatening experience our Babylonian captivity caused by our sinful ways? God is not only committed to saving individuals from dying to our sins, but extends that same mercy to all who might leave our Babylonian captivity, or sinful way behind, and return to our friendship with He who created us. God is both refuge and strength for us, a help always ready in trouble. So we shall not be afraid, though the earth be in turmoil.